Brain Training for Anxiety. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. In this video, I want to share with you what anxiety really is. I want you to learn to listen to your anxiety, whether you want to or not, so you can hear what it's telling you. Then secondarily, I want to share with you what the anxiety brain performance pattern looks like and what it involves, so that you know that usually when it comes to anxiety, at a certain point, you're stuck in the anxious brain pattern. So I want you to know what that looks like so that number three, you can learn how to heal that pattern using brain training. So let's dive in. This conversation, this video comes from a conversation that I was having with a friend the other night, celebrating my husband's birthday, and the conversation of anxiety came up. So it was not the time or place to share all this, even though I did share a little. If you've met me, you know what I'm talking about, but I didn't go into the full explanation, not the time or place. So I wanted to make this video for that friend so that she knows this is very common and there's a solution. Medication doesn't have to be involved. Medication is like a Band-Aid. And if you're bleeding out, you need a Band-Aid. So I'm not anti-medication when it comes to that step. Bleeding out, you're in crisis, you feel so anxious, you can't perform, you can't go to work, it's consuming you. It's hot, fast energy and it will not release its hold on you. I get it. There's a time and place for medication. But if you have a deep wound that needs healing, a Band-Aid isn't gonna cut it. You need stitches, my friend. And brain training is the stitches that your brain pattern of anxiety needs to heal. So the misconception about anxiety is that it's bad. It does not feel good. It does not feel good, but it is telling you something. And if you don't listen to your symptoms, then when you take medication, it makes the voice go away so you can't hear it. But the problem with that is it's still there. It hasn't gone anywhere. What medication typically does is lower the power in your brain. So this fast, hot energy of anxiety becomes dulled. So it's still there. It's just not burning as hot. And if you've taken anxiety medication, you probably know what I mean. You feel numbed out. You feel lack of feeling. But underneath it, you know the anxiety isn't gone. So I know you might be thinking, this woman's crazy telling me I have to feel what the anxiety is trying to tell me. It's telling you something. And this comes from a person who ignored symptoms for years, practically a decade. And I ignored symptoms because I didn't want them. I didn't want to know what they were telling me. And what my symptoms told me was that my home was filled with mold and I was being poisoned every single minute of every single day. But I didn't want to bring that upon myself or my family. I didn't know what it was. So that's why I want you to understand you don't know what it is, but you can't hide and run from it because if you do, it just gets worse. So when I moved into my home, I was super healthy. Over years, very slowly, but very surely, things started to happen to me and my health was declining. Then I hit a tipping point where my health declined rapidly. And I said to the Hebbs, this house is killing me, my friend. I'm moving out. I don't know what it is, but I know it's hurting me. And it was the air quality. It can't be seen. It can't be smelled. It can't be tasted. But once it's tested, I knew it was there. And what I thought deep down, my intuition was right. So this is what I want for you. You listen to your symptoms. You don't ignore them and you don't throw large amounts of medication on top of them because they will stay there and they will fester. People tell me all the time that something happened to them, but don't worry about it because they tucked it in the back of their brain. And I say to people, it's back there festering, my friend. We have to pull it out, move through it, resolve it, integrate it, and then regulate your brain so you're not stuck in this neuro-rigid dysfunctional, anxiety, anxious brain pattern for the rest of your life. It doesn't have to be that way. Brain training can help you. So I want you to know, if you're struggling with anxiety, there's another way. There's a permanent way to heal the brain pattern at the core and to look at the symptoms and make bold changes in your life. So back to my mold story, bold changes had to be made. And I was not willing to make them at first until I realized the magnitude that the situation was having on my life. It wasn't my life that was the problem. It was the situation and its magnitude. So I moved out of my home for a year. I actually had to live 3 different places and ultimately buy an entire other home to stay in while my home was being renovated. It was a smaller home that didn't fit me and my 5 kids and the Hubs and Chewbacca, my dog. So we got a smaller home while our home was being fixed. These are big, bold moves to fix the situation that was ruining my life and my health. Big, bold moves were taken, but guess what? When I did that, and I did a lot of self-healing, everything I'm talking to you about, I've done for myself, and my brain came back online, my body came back online, my life is continuing to come back online in more beautiful ways than ever. And of course, if you can have a framework shift, then you can go that what seemingly was the worst thing that ever happened to me is actually becoming one of the biggest gifts that I've ever had. Because not only do I have a completely renovated and very clean and the cleanest air on earth home, that experience brought my family closer together. It helped the Hubs and I work out some of our toxic dynamics. He did not want to move out with me. And I'm like, you know what, friend? I got to move out anyway, because I know you don't believe me, but I know this and I've got to do what's right for me. I love you, but I've got to do what's right for me. That was one of the first times in my life that I started doing what I needed, opposed to doing what everybody else needed. Now, honestly, the first place we moved, I knew it wasn't going to be right in my heart. I did it because it was close to my husband's work. It was close to friends for my kids, but it wasn't clean, and I knew that. But I ignored that, and I moved there anyways, which inherently I had to move out a couple months later. So I could have avoided that step had I really dug deeper, but this is a journey, and that was a really important part of the journey to get me where I am today. This journey is there for the taking for you. All right, let's go to number 2 so I can tell you how you get there. The number 1 thing you have to do is regulate and create more neuroplasticity in your brain and get it moving in the right direction. There's a scientific law called Hebbs Law. Hebbs Law says neurons that fire together wire together. So if you have an anxiety brain pattern and you go into the world using anxiety and stress that comes from it, and I say it with this face because you can't help but use it because it is the pattern that produces it. That's what we have to do, break this negative feedback loop through something that's called anti-Hebbian learning. Anti-Hebbian learning means we start making a more functional brain, a brain that's less anxious and stressed and inherently calmer and more focused. And then you learn how to go into your life feeling just a little bit calmer and more focused to start. And then the flywheel of the positive feedback loop takes hold. Hebb's law in the opposite direction of joy, peace, and happiness. It starts wiring in the calm, focused brain pattern. That hot, fast energy, the very fastest energy called high beta, extra fast speed keeps coming down. Calm focus keeps coming up. But guess what'll happen when that happens? Just like the mold situation, it's gonna be there for you to look at. You're going to have to listen to your anxiety symptoms because most people aren't born with anxiety. Anxiety is not a neurodevelopmental disorder. It's one that comes through. Yes, there's a nature component for some people. Nature meaning apples don't fall far from the tree. Brains don't fall far from the tree. So if you have a family that has had anxiety, historically speaking, genetically speaking, then this is your opportunity to familially change the use of that pattern using brain training. So when you start wiring in this healthier pattern, you can break the nature component. You change the nurture component, your environment. You look around, and if your environment is wounding you, it might not be mold spores in the air. It might be the relationship dynamics. It might be the job you don't like going to. It might be the way that you interact with your children. It may be friendships that no longer serve you. When you really look at it all, the nurture part, the environment, you can navigate differently. These are the three ends of regulating and rewiring your brain. Nature, nurture, and navigation. When it comes to nature, there's a field of healthcare called epigenetics. You can rise above your genes. We know this. It's proven. Neurofeedback brain training is one of the modalities proven to help you do that. Because inherently, you can change the inner workings of your brain pattern. You slow it down from this super fast speed to the speed of calm focus. And when you slow your brain pattern down, you move through the world differently. And you get into problem-solving mode instead of problem-seeking mode, and it starts to shed off of you. And this starts by rewiring and regulating your brain. I've created a new program to make brain training easy for people to get into. It's called Brain Training 101. Just like if you decided to go to the university right now, the first thing that you would take is a 101 class, an introductory class. This program is accessible and affordable, and I want you in it with me. It's a monthly community where I'm going to teach you how to rewire your brain using your mind, your body, and most importantly, technology. When you get into Brain Training 101, I'll encourage you to purchase the Brain Training Headband. If you do it in my program, you get the best pricing. Then I'm gonna teach you how to use it. And I'm going to teach you how to interpret all the data this Brain Training Headband can give you. It's amazing. You're going to have a very affordable tool to help your own cause. Now, if you've been struggling with anxiety for a really long time, it means that likely you have a very dysregulated brain. And with high levels of dysfunction, it can be more difficult to use the headband in Brain Training 101. But when you get into that program, I can teach you about QEEG brain mapping. I can teach you about professional neurofeedback coaching with me, if that's something that you want eventually. You don't have to do that because there's going to be new content every single month in Brain Training 101. But if you're having difficulty succeeding, working with me personally can take you very far in a short amount of time. But what I want you to know is you don't have to struggle with anxiety. You don't have to continue to suffer in silence and only tell a friend later at night after you've been hanging out because you're suffering in silence all day long and nobody knows that you're pretending to feel great, but your soul is wounded on the inside. I was listening to Taylor Swift's new song. Yeah, I'm a secret Swiftie. That's what I like to call myself. And she has a new song that's called I Can Do It With a Broken Heart. That song cracks me up because there's a line that says she's so depressed that she acts like it's her birthday every day. And for some people, that's what they feel. They feel anxious and depressed all day, every day. So they're so high key, so nobody knows. I don't want that for you. I want to know your pain and suffering, and I want you to know it doesn't have to be that way. I've helped thousands of people. I can help you. All right. So your brain hack strategy for the day is think about those three ends, nature, nurture, and navigate. Realize all three of them can be changed and that putting some medication on it isn't going to change any of them. What is going to change is the stitches of healing your brain, neurofeedback brain training, and now it's easier than ever to start. So I hope to see you in Brain Training 101. And if you're looking to spend some time with me and see exactly what your brain holds in terms of anxiety and the levels of dysfunction, a QEEG brain map would be the best first start. So until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.